problem is all inside your head, she said to me. The answer is easy if you take it logically.
Hey guys, Mike Heller.
So my old Graylab timer started getting hung up, and I thought I'd take it apart, clean what there is to clean, maybe re-lubricate the gears inside, see what's what. So here's the way you do this stuff. If you look carefully at the knob here, right here, there's a place to get a small screwdriver in, and you, I've already loosened this up, but you unscrew that there, and then this knob comes off, and you want to see where that hole is in the knob, and you can see it's on that back ring. It's not on the knurled part of it, but where that hole is, that hole is going to go back in, lined up with this hole here on the second hand. The second hand comes off, and if you look carefully, the minute hand, right over here at the end of it, there's a tiny little screw here. So if your minute hand is slipping or not working right, you can tighten this screw up here. It'll take even a smaller screwdriver than this, and that'll tighten up the minute hand. And then the second hand gets tightened up when you put the knob back on. You can see here that the second hand doesn't touch the minute hand. When you put it back together, make sure that they're not rubbing on each other. And just to be sure, put a little of that white lithium grease on those two surfaces that could contact. But they should be about this far apart. On mine, there's three screws on each outside surface. Some of the newer ones have plastic clips or pop rivets that you have to drill out. But either way, back comes off and that exposes the inside of the timer. All pretty basic. This one is probably from the early 1970s or maybe the late 60s. I put a little bit of grease. I use white lithium grease, and I put a little bit of grease on the gears here. And if you look carefully inside, there's three more gears that can be lubricated here. I think you can see down the back side there. Let's see if I can set this down and point, but back in here, there's a couple more small gears. So the way I'm lubricating this stuff is I like Q-tips. Let me set the camera down here and see if I can make this. So I take a little white lithium grease and I make a little dot of it on a piece of paper towel or whatever. And then I take a Q-tip and I take a side cutters, wire cutters, and I cut the Q-tip off, take it and roll it around in your hand a little bit to get all of the fabric going the same way, and then I'm cutting it two-thirds of the way down and cut a big piece of the tip off, but that leaves me with this nice little piece of Q-tip that still has a little cotton on the end of it, and I can take this and I roll this all in the same direction. Just the same direction that when you twisted it to before you cut it off. Keep rolling it in the same direction to get the threads going the same way. And then you've got a little bit of lubricant on here. And you can take that and get down here onto the gear. You don't need a lot because this will transfer over onto the next gear. And you do that on all three gears, and that's pretty much all you can do on the inside. I cleaned everything up. I was getting a little bit of rust along one of the seams down here, so I sprayed a little WD-40 on that to maybe slow that up. But that's it. Put the backpack on. If you got a bad switch, the switches are easy enough to change. But all I ever use is the on and off switch you can hear.
That time focus switch has never been used. It clicks like it's new. Listen to this one. That one's got some wear on it. The timer, I don't really time anything with it. I set it up and I watch the second hand. I watch it go around twice. I kind of note wherever the minute hand is, but I'm just always watching the second hand when I'm developing or when this timer is coming into play. Maybe on film, if I was using this on film, maybe I would set it for 8 minutes or whatever, and then you're watching it every 30 seconds to do your agitation or whatever your sequence is. But this has been a good timer. It'll last a long time. Hopefully, it'll last longer. Going back to work.
The problem is all inside your head, she said to me. The answer is easy if you take it logically. I'd like to help you in your struggle.